looking for ways to celebrate our diversity. And we are going to try to reach out to every boy and girl, as well as every adult, to bring them in to working on behalf of our country. I have a very positive and optimistic view about what we can do together. That's why the slogan of my campaign is Stronger Together. Because I think if we work together, if we overcome the divisiveness that sometimes sets Americans against one another, and instead we make some big goals, and I set forth some big goals, getting the economy to work for everyone, not just those at the top, making sure that we have the best education system from preschool through college, and making it affordable, and so much else. If we set those goals and we go together to try and achieve them, there's nothing, in my opinion, that America can't do. So that's why I hope that we will come together in this campaign. Obviously, I'm hoping to earn your vote. I'm hoping to be elected in November. And I can promise you, I will work with every American. I want to be the president for all Americans, regardless of your political beliefs, where you come from, what you look like, your religion. I want us to heal our country and bring it together. Because that's, I think, the best way for us to get the future that our children and our grandchildren deserve.
Senator Clinton, thank you for talking up to me.
Well, I actually agree with that. I agree with everything she said. I began this campaign because I was so tired of seeing such foolish things happen to our country. This is a great country. This is a great land. I've gotten to know the people of the country over the last year and a half that I've been doing this as a politician. I cannot believe I'm saying that about myself, but I guess I have been a politician. And my whole concept was to make America great again. When I watch the deals being made, when I watch what's happening there, some market things like Obamacare, where your health insurance and healthcare is going up on numbers that are astronomical, about 68%, 59%, 71%. When I look at the Iran deal and how bad a deal it is for us, it's an insider transaction for giving back $150 billion to a terrorist state, really vulnerable one terrorist state. We made them a strong country from a very weak country just 3 years ago. When I look at all the things that I've seen, all the potential our country has, we have such tremendous potential, whether it's in business and trade, where we're doing so badly. Last year we had an almost $800 billion trade deficit, whether it's trade with other countries. We had an $800 billion deficit. It's hard to believe. Inconceivable. We said he's making these deals. We're going to make trade deals. We're going to score more. We're going to bring back law and order. Just a place where we shot to kill. And this is happening on a weekly basis. We have to bring back respect to law enforcement. At the same time, we have to take care of people in this country and justice. But I will do things that haven't been done, including fixing and making our inner cities better for the African-American citizens of Australia and for the Latinos, the Spaniards. Years ago, the evacuee was left. So because of bad judgment, and I will tell you, I will take care of ISIS. Things are not looking into much more important things and much bigger things.
Just for the record, though, are you saying that what you said on that bus 11 years ago, that you did not actually kiss women without consent, but the ones women without consent?
I have great respect for women. You know there's no respect for women around you. You're a poor person, you know your enemies, but frankly, you hear these things, I say. And I was embarrassed by it. But I have tremendous respect for women.
Have you ever held a feeling?
Have respect for women. And I will tell you, no, I have not. And I will tell you that I'm going to make our country safe. We're going to have lawyers in our country, which we don't have now. People are falling into our country. And they're coming into the Middle East and other places. We're going to make America safe again. We're going to make America great again, but we're going to make America safe again. And we're going to make America wealthy again, because if we don't do that, it sounds harsh to say, but we have to build up the wealth of our nations. Now other nations are taking our jobs and they're taking our wealth.
Thank you for coming on the show. Thank you for coming on the
show. Well, like everyone else, I spent a lot of time thinking for the last 48 hours about what we heard. And you know, with prior Republican nominees for president, I disagree with them on politics, policies, principles, but I never questioned their fitness to serve. Donald Trump is different. I said starting back in June that he was not fit to be president and commander-in-chief. And many Republicans and independents have said the same thing. What we all saw and heard on Friday was Donald talking about women, what he thinks about women, what he does to women, and he has said that the video doesn't represent who he is, but I think it's clear to anyone who heard it that it represents exactly who he is, because we've seen this throughout the campaign. We've seen him insult women, we've seen him rate women on their appearance, ranking them from 1 to 10. We've seen him embarrass women on TV and on Twitter. We saw him after the first debate spend nearly a week denigrating a former Miss Universe in the harshest, most personal terms. So, yes, this is who Donald Trump is. But it's not only women, and it's not only this video that raises questions about his fitness to be our president. Because he has also targeted immigrants, African Americans, Latinos, people with disabilities, POWs, Muslims, and so many others. So this is who Donald Trump is, and the question for us, the question our country must answer, is that this is not who we are. That's why, to go back to your question, I want to send a message, we all should, to every boy and girl, and indeed to the entire world, that America already is great, but we are great because we are good. And we will respect one another, and we will work with one another, and we will celebrate our diversity. These are very important values to me, because this is the America that I know and love. And I can pledge to you tonight that this is the America that I will serve if I'm so fortunate enough to become your president. And we want to get to some questions who are on our mind.
I assume I am.
Yes, you can respond to that.
It's just the words, folks. It's just the words. Those words I've been hearing for many years. I heard them when they were running for the Senate in New York with Hillary, who's going to bring back John Strauss to New York. And she failed. I've heard them. Talking about the inner city.